Permagon Ultra, a beautiful iridescent glow where everyone was watching the beautiful scenery that reminds them of just how beautiful the universe can be. The person whom you see here narrating in the background and controlling the view, apparently, is Norton. Norton basically works for a company that takes people on trips where they discover the beauty of the universe. The company's called Astral Dreams, and the job doesn't really pay much, but Norton does it anyways, as he really doesn't have much else to do. And he also has other personal reasons to do this job. Here we're introduced to Norton's close friend and colleague, Andrews, who's enjoying himself inside the office. We see him saying hello to a bunch of passengers of his ship, but he really doesn't appreciate them much, as we realize that he looks down on people that have better positions than he does. After Norton gets there, they talk about a few customer complaints and some paperwork, and their job was pretty much over for the week, so they try to relax. And outside, we see a very strange couple, an old lady and a robot, heading their way. Inside their office in Astral Dreams, Norton and Andrews discuss their projects for next week, and there were a lot of projects that were upcoming, including a wedding. Norton says that he'll take on a few of them, and after wrapping up what they're gonna do next week, Norton gets up to go home, declining his friend's offer to go grab a couple of beers. Norton declined because his girlfriend Barbara was waiting for him, and here we realize that she's a bit of a hard ass, as she wants to make the move to Primo Central, a location that's more prestigious than the location that they're in now, and why Norton works so hard at his job has something to do with putting up an application, which he already did, and he tells Andrews that it's in the process, and that it's probably gonna happen real soon. And just before they wrapped up their conversation and Norton left, they hear a bang on the door. Andrews begins to scream, saying that they're closed, but the person on the other side of the door just kept banging. And when Norton opened, he found that it's some old lady. He tells her that they're not open and that she has to come back next week, but the lady just kept staring at him, and her robot that was next to her explains that she's actually deaf. The lady introduces herself as Irma Gordon, and she requests that they take her on a tour. Norton tries to be nice and tries to give her a pamphlet so she can use other guides to go on her tour, but he's very surprised when he hears her say that the tour that she wants to go on is a tour to the planet Earth. Andrews cuts in the conversation and tries to get rid of the old lady, but her companion, the robot, explains that she's from a planet called Riga 2, and when Andrews hears that she actually wants to go to Earth, he says that she's not only deaf, but she's actually crazy. And the robot goes on to explain that the old woman traveled a very long distance and that she's willing to pay a hefty amount of money, which the robot has in hand, for anyone that would take her on a tour to Earth. Andrews did explain that they can't take her to Earth because Earth doesn't exist anymore, but when he heard just how much money the old lady was offering, he was incredibly shocked and he couldn't say anything more. And next we see Andrews going back inside his office, making a bunch of calls and running a search for planets that look very similar to Earth. Norton was pretty confused by this. He was thinking about the money, but he couldn't really figure out what Andrews was doing. He didn't actually think that Andrews would trick the old lady and take her to a weird solar system that resembles Earth's. Norton tells his friend that he's not gonna do this or blow his chances of going to Primo Central with his girlfriend if they get caught. But just before he declines and leaves, Andrews tells them that he needs him to go because the craft needs two operators. And at the same time, since he was late to get home, his girlfriend Barbara video calls him at the office. As they were having a conversation, she seemed a little pissed and she tells him to watch a video call, and apparently, his process to go to Primo Central got rejected. And this here becomes the motivation for Norton to fly with Andrews to an unknown solar system, claiming that it's Earth so they can take a lot of money from the old lady. The trip is about a week long, and the money was a lot, and so we see Andrews and Norton making their way to M43, which is a planet that they claim is actually Earth. They were about 4 days away from their location, and Norton and Andrews were taking care of their VIP customer. At some point, the old lady starts talking about her grandma that died when she was 279 years old. Irma herself was actually 300 and some change, and she kept talking about a story that her grandmother told her when she was a kid. It was about a place called Carolina. Her grandfather was a logger, and there would be a waterfall there, and they would go into it naked and swim. And Irma remembers how her grandmother was fond of that memory, and how she told her that it was the best feeling that she's ever felt before. And Irma goes on to say to Norton that she wants to go to this place, it's called Carolina, and specifically, it's a place called Elk River. But when she tells him that that's where she wants to go, Norton gets a little uncomfortable because he's not technically taking her to Earth, and he looks to her robot and explains to him that they can't really find specific destinations. But both the robot and Norton don't really say much, as Irma was too old and she genuinely thought that they'd take her to this place, Carolina, and she'd see the waterfall. Later we see her robot confronting Norton about why they didn't complete any paperwork, but Norton just tries to shrug it off. But when he hears the robot telling him that the old lady is really old and that she only has 2 months to live, Norton starts to regret everything that he's doing. After another day, as Norton presents the complimentary hot beverage to his customer, Irma tries to use this teleprompter machine to communicate with him, as she kind of felt a little lonely. As they converse, Irma asks him a bunch of questions about his life, and he tells her that his plan is actually to make it to Primo Central. She asks him who he's gonna go there with, and he tells her that he's gonna get there with his girlfriend Barbara, but when she kept asking him why he didn't marry her and if he loved her, he kind of got a little confused as to why he's doing anything he's doing with his life, and he decides to leave her room. After everybody goes to sleep, and Andrews puts the ship on autopilot, Irma's robot gets inside the captain's quarters, and manually overrides the controls, and learns that they're not actually heading to Earth, but just some random distant planet. And the next day, they make it to their destination, the solar system that houses the fake Earth. Norton was feeling really uncomfortable by the entire situation, but he decides to play along. And that day, as they were taking their break, they talk about what they would do with all the money that they would get after their tour. Andrews talks about retirement, and how he just wants to rest and maybe be the passenger for once. But Norton goes on to say something quite odd. He goes on to say that maybe they should tell the old lady the truth because he's really starting to feel the guilt of what he's doing. He even goes on to say that they're actually con artists, but Andrews explains that even their original job was actually tricking people, as they deceive them by showing them colors that don't really exist and making them hear sounds that are amplified but not actually there. Before their conversation intensifies some more, they get called by the old lady, and Norton goes up to check on her. Irma was having problems with her robot, as she wanted to dress in this really old dress, and the robot didn't quite know how to hook it. And as Norton puts on the dress for her, she talks about how her granddad used to do that to her grandma, and after he was done, she asks him what she looked like, and he tells her that she looks beautiful. And the next thing that happened was quite a bit of a surprise, as Irma kisses Norton, and she shows him a picture of her grandparents. And weirdly enough, a photo of her grandfather looks exactly like Norton, and her grandmother actually looks like her. She explains that she actually dreamt of Norton, and that's why she came to that location, and why she wanted him to take her to Earth. Norton was amazed by all of this revelation, and he really didn't know what to make of it. And this was the last step that he required to genuinely question if he really, really did, in fact, love his girlfriend Barbara, and he makes a call to her back on her planet. Their conversation ends after a fight, and after Norton asks her if she ever dreams about him, and he reveals to her that he's never really quite dreamt about her. After ending the call, Norton makes it to the main deck, where finally, Irma sees the solar system that she thinks is Earth's. From afar, she can see Mars, but it's not red, it's actually blue. And all the planets were all just different somehow. And she begins to freak out and tells Andrew that everybody knows that Mars is red. And as both Norton and Andrews try to calm her down, something surprising happens. Her personal robot that actually knows the truth of their destination goes on to say that about 60 years ago, there was an electromagnetic event that changed everything within the solar system, which is actually a lie. Andrews and Norton realize that the robot is playing along, as it's realized that there was really no point in telling the old lady the truth, as she was gonna die really soon anyways, and instead of telling her the truth and devastating her heart, maybe it was better to lie anyways. As the tour proceeds, we see that it wasn't really enough for Irma, and she wanted to get closer to Earth. She wanted to see how blue and green it was, and Andrews manipulates the color, and when she opens her eyes after closing it, they're hoping when she opens it, she'll finally see the right colors. She really does this time. And seeing the colors, even though they were manipulated by Andrews, wasn't really enough for Irma, as she wanted to land on the planet. And out of guilt and some kind of misplaced loyalty to her, even though Andrews says that they can't land on the planet, Norton tells her that they can, and knowing that they would cause a lot of damage to their craft, they land it on the barren planet. At this point, Andrews was completely pissed, and Irma asks to go outside the ship to see the planet on her own. He tells her that they don't have suits and they have to leave immediately, but Norton gets these auxiliary suits, and Irma and Norton walk outside to the barren planet. And weirdly enough, after walking a certain amount of distance, they can hear waterfalls and birds chirping, and it's almost as if they found a forest. Andrews realizes that they went outside, and he confronts the robot and tells them to get them back inside immediately, as they're gonna run out of oxygen at any point. But the robot didn't care, and neither did Norton, even when Andrews told him that he's gonna die at any point. But something miraculous happens here, where Irma and Norton take off their helmets, and here we see Irma finally reliving the fantasy that she wanted to relive for hundreds of years, and Norton realizing that he's actually been another person all along, who's actually Bill Gordon, who's married to Irma's grandmother. And here we see them be their actual selves, and swimming in that lake that Irma always wanted to swim in, the two lost souls are happily reunited.